Now, chain stores are another kind of fixed retail stores. Okay, so let's understand what are those. See, chain stores or multiple shops, which are normally we call them, these are the network of retail shops. So what would happen? They would have a chain of shops across different cities. For example, you would have heard about Reebok, Bata, Enrich Salon. So generally salon would have, once the salon starts working and it's up and running, and if it becomes successful, you will find the same brand salon in across the different cities. Similarly, you would have seen the Bata stores across various cities where you can buy the shoes of that company, that is of Bata company, by going to that store. So the features are, here they are located at generally populous localities. Okay, they have a centralized manufacturing or procurement. So what happens is, let's take example for Bata. So Bata would be doing central manufacturing only at one place, right? Similarly, the procurement would be also done at one place for other chain stores, and then from there the goods are sent to all these chain stores. So to take an example of procurement of goods, take this in mind. Let's understand the salon services. Now salon would be buying a lot of products, beauty products, which would be used on the final consumer. So the procurement there would be done on a centralized basis. Now these chain stores are under a direct supervision of a branch manager. Now these branch manager, these branches would be controlled directly by the head office. Each of the branches is controlled by the head office itself. Remember, they have fixed prices, and whatever are the daily sales that are accounted or the details are given to the head office, and whatever is the cash collected from daily sales, that would be deposited in the local bank account. Remember, in these kind of stores or chain stores, the inspectors come and supervise the day-to-day operations from time to time basis. Now let's understand the advantages and disadvantages of chain stores. The first is economies of scale. Why? Because they are doing a centralized production of goods or procurement of goods. Second is elimination of middleman. See, if Bata would have been selling the shoes through some other means, the cost would have increased. So because they are selling it directly, that is the company selling directly through chain of stores the goods they produce, hence the middleman gets eliminated, and because of that the price also decreases. Now there are no bad debts, the reason being because every sale is made on cash basis. Transfer of goods. See, here the transfer of goods take place from the manufacturer to the chain stores, okay, so which is very conveniently done, and there are no hazards or there are no problems in doing that compared to other retail shops. As and when the demand is there, the goods are transferred. Sometimes what happens is, let's say a particular store has a demand for XYZ product, whereas the other chain store would not have it. So in case if there is shortage of goods, immediately that other chain store can transfer the goods to this particular chain store who is seeing the demand of XYZ goods. It reduces risk, or there is diffusion of risk, because they are carrying out the business or they are selling the goods through means of chain of stores. Okay, because they are operating at such a large scale, so obviously there is low cost which they have to bear compared to other stores which we discussed. Now there is a flexibility. I gave you an example. The flexibility is, in case if the goods are not in demand at one store, those can be sent to another store where those goods are in demand. Now the disadvantages are limited selection of goods. Now if you go to Bata, you will only get shoes manufactured by XYZ, so there is a limited selection of goods. Lack of initiative, the reason being because they have to sell the same goods, they have to manufacture the same goods as such and then sell the same through their chain stores. They do not take much of initiative in making those sales happen. There is a lack of personal touch because the goods are just displayed and all you have to do is select the one which you require and buy it. Now, if there is a change in demand, suppose let's say if there is a new company which comes in with better shoes, so chances are that the XYZ might make losses. Okay, so in that scenario, what would happen when there is a change in demand? Now, because these chain stores are only selling Bata products, so they cannot go ahead and buy other companies' shoes and sell it to the final consumer. So that is a disadvantage of having a chain store.